There is growing demand for sand in Kasese district as the population continues to grow. The result is that sand is being extracted far more quickly than it can be naturally replaced. Experts say this causes environmental degradation and jeopardizes the natural ecosystem, which may escalate into disasters. Environmentalists have warned residents on clearing vegetation around riverbanks, which leaves the soils bare, hence fueling floods.
Sand is being excavated from the river, and you find that now the sand structure, because the soils have structures, that structure is disorganized, and you find that now when there is a minor flood, the whole area is eroded.
But to the miners and some leaders, the activity is just similar to desilting, something environmentalists disagree with.
Engaged in sand mining, so that just in case the river floods again, water can get a way through.
Sand miners, if they don't encroach on the river banks, they are doing a similar activity of desilting. If they don't encroach on the banks, but if they encroach on the banks, they are giving a new way to the river to again escalate to the people's gardens.
Natural resource activists have called for regulated sand mining on River Nyamamba to avoid any catastrophes that may arise due to the activity.
We should do a proper environmental impact assessment so that we know which people to give the licenses to operate than just allowing anyone. Mine sand.
Augustine Coley, the environment officer for Kasese District, says they are trying to set up sand mining guidelines to aid in environmental conservation.
Coming up with sand mining guidelines to guide these people who are mining the sand to mine it sustainably so that we can have our construction industry prosper as we maintain the river channels.
We are working with sister agencies of government to ensure that we put people off that river to that level.
While sand might be considered a natural resource for construction and other related activities, the unregulated extraction of it exposes the riverbanks and bed, which may later result in climate change challenges. Story by Gilbert Mohanguzi for the news.